Hello and welcome back to Pure on the Road. I'm Sam Maracini back at Techfest 22 once again in the event deck. I'm in our partner pavilion and I am with Brian Puccinelli, part of Veeam. What's up,
How's dude? It going? How's it going, Sam? It's great to see you in the flesh.
In the flesh again, dude. It feels like yesterday, but yet forever ago. We were in Austin, Texas,
in the convention center
doing this. It's quite a difference from then to now.
It has been, yeah.
And you know what? That was the very introduction of our partner advisories.
Yeah,
that's
right.
You guys being part of it. We moved on to the second version. What's Veeam been up to?
Yeah, so the partnership is fantastic. We've seen just, so the two companies, I'll start with this, the two companies are kind of cut from the same cloth, right? We really go after the market or the problems that we solve for our customers are very similar. We bring both our expertise on the data protection side, Pure on the primary and production side. Some of our guys are former analysts at Gartner, and they like to say, I love this tagline, is when you modernize production storage, you gotta modernize protection.
Modernize data protection, absolutely.
That's right.
And it makes complete sense. And that's, the synergies are all around customer business outcomes. And we think backup, and you immediately think ransomware, and you think disaster recovery. And how have you guys worked to incorporate all
Yeah, so we got a really really great story around ransomware, and we've had, because we have so many customers, there's several thousand customers that are using the snapshot integration between Veeam and Pure with the telemetry data of Pure One. It's amazing, and that's growing quarter over quarter very consistently. But from a ransomware perspective, Pure has a great solution around Safe Mode snapshots,
absolutely,
right?
Absolutely, yes.
And from Veeam side, we have a solution called Veeam One, and it does a lot of the monitoring and detection when things are kind of out of band, if a network is potentially hacked, and sometimes these guys lay dormant. So one thing that Veeam does a great job of is actually doing a lot of analyzing of the data from the customers about what they've experienced over time. And a lot of times these ransomware, you know, basically cyber threats come, they're already embedded into backup data, sometimes like a year in advance, right?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
What Veeam does from a monitoring and detection perspective actually really can demonstrate when potentially you guys are at risk, right? A customer's at risk, sorry, not you. And on the FlashBlade side, yeah, it could be your data.
Yeah, it could be my data.
On the FlashBlade side, the rapid restore capability and the safe modes and the immutability around safe mode snapshots is like a home run type solution between the two of us. And it's been great.
It makes sense, and that's where we pull that all together, right? So
yep.
it's not only about providing that, but it's also about integrating to the application layer.
Correct.
Right? Because we have the storage, uncomplicate your storage forever. You guys are going to bring that data protection element, and then it's a matter of also integrating with applications above that. So that's the trifecta where everything pulls together. And one of the reasons, by the way, why we're 100% channel focused, because we need the channel partners to make that happen.
That's right. 100%. And same thing on the Veeam side. We're 100% channel focused. And one thing I'll bring up here is, since I got you here, is V12, version 12 of Veeam is going to be coming in the second half.
Okay.
So that's coming soon. And as a part of that payload in V12, that's our big major release from a Veeam perspective, is the API integration 2.0 for snapshotting and orchestration, as well as replication.
Okay.
So this opens the door a little bit further from a Veeam and Pure customer perspective, is to now do some things like real-time DR or true DR, right? Failing over on one site from site A to site B and then recovering that data. And then another use case, there's a whole bunch of use cases that we can talk through. That's one, DR.
Sure.
And then the second real core use case around there is DevOps, right?
Okay.
Again, doing development and regression testing on the application, on production data, because that's replicated near real time, it's near production data, there's a big story there from a DevOps perspective. And then the performance on FlashArray C, FlashBlade on the back end kind of makes all of that come together.
So you're talking DevOps, we got Portworx that's going to work in that area, you're talking FlashArray C, I love that.
Yep.
That integration, the rapid restore, it's all about that rapid restore, right? And providing that to you so that you can then turn around and give your customers
Most of these legacy solutions, not going to call them out, right? But they're great at backing the data up, dedupe, all that other stuff, right? But those are legacy, like old plays. What Veeam and Pure bring to the table is really the recoverability, the granular recoverability, recover exactly what you want when you want it, right? And then the speed, we're talking hours instead of weeks, right? Hours of restore from an environment perspective is huge, right? And
Absolutely.
Now the FlashBlade S, like, that's a huge product.
FlashBlade S is big. We released that earlier today. That's going to add a lot of capabilities. It also gives our customers some flexibility when it comes to data packs across products. There's some really interesting things there. But what I love is the partnership.
Yep.
Right? You guys are right here. Thank you for being part of this Techfest.
You bet,
we're
Sam. We're happy to be here.
We're outside.
Even Joe Biden came today.
Joe came. Yep. I saw stilt walkers going by here. There were some roller skaters coming through here. You see those things?
It was incredible.
And I hear the band getting ready. There must be some kind of party.
The music's always great.
You got to think about that because you know Techfest might be a thing that sticks around. Might see you in 23.
Yeah, there you go.
I hope so.
So
do I, Brad. Thanks for spending some time with me. Thank you, guys. Hit that subscribe button for more. Lots coming from Techfest 22. We'll talk to you soon.